I'm having a tough time. Should I be in the walk or the stand lane?
18:19.
Look at the accessible bathroom at the Minneapolis St. Paul Airport. Beautiful. They forgot to bring the aisle chair down right away, so then they gave us a complimentary drink that we actually ended up not using. And then since the flight was over 3 hours, I decided to watch a movie. I saw The Upside, and it was really good. It's about this guy who has quadriplegia and is looking for a caregiver. Because of the high altitude, the Cheez-It bag inflated with more air. It was so weird. So I had that as a snack on the plane, and I also had some orange juice. The flight was really good. There wasn't a whole lot of turbulence. And yeah, we arrived in Vegas. This was the first night just kind of touring around, Ubering. Here's a little walkway that gets you from one casino to the next, which was really nice. It was an accessible way to do it.
Yeah, hey, wait. Hold on, wait. One second. Okay, whoa.
Here we are having a nice lunch. Got some chicken tacos, beans, rice, chips, water. Sophia already got into a bonus, her first spin. 40 cents. You just won 40 cents.
I'm rich.
They say I'm sweet. For the most part, it was a smooth wheel for me. There were some areas that were bumpier than others, and later into the evening, my legs would spasm and kick up and down. So I had to make sure my feet wouldn't fall off the foot plate. But for the most part, it was smooth sailing on the surfaces. Right, sometimes you have to go a different path. But it's still a path and it makes it there. You just gotta take the ramp, cruise down, get some momentum, hard turn, and you're with the pack. No deal.
No deal.
There's a lot of good signage in the casinos, but I didn't see a sign that said, hey, there's an elevator this way. A lot of the elevators were tucked behind corners, so we just decided to take this escalator because we couldn't find the elevator. Another really cool thing that was in this casino, they had a companion bathroom, which is perfect for someone that needs assistance with going to the bathroom or if they had an accident. So, you know, I thought that was really cool to see that inclusivity and just being accommodating for people.
Meet the bug.
Honey, these smoothies are the best smoothies I've ever had. Cheers.
Hold your breath. Make a wish. Count to three.
Come with me, and you'll be in a world of pure imagination.
Then we wheeled over and saw the Bellagio fountains, which were beautiful. It matches to the music that's playing. We're in New York, got the parking meter. Waiting for some crepes. I love downhill ramps, check this out. Another great feature was the tram system, because it went from Excalibur to Luxor, or you could also go from Excalibur to Mandalay Bay, and then it also goes back to Excalibur.
Mandalay Bay wave pool, here we come! I'm a lifeguard! I'm a lifeguard.
Here's the Raiders Stadium that's being built. This was the view from the hotel at Mandalay Bay. We went up there to dry off, and then later in the video you'll see me getting in and out of the wave pool, so stay tuned for that. Ooh, we have 44 seconds. It's actually a lot of time. One thing that I noticed that happened a lot was the fact that people would stand on their phones talking and they'd be right where the curb cut was. So I'd have to say excuse me and then go past them and then carry on. It's just kind of funny how people will stay in that spot. You should always try to be to the corner or an edge where no one will be walking, wheeling, or need access.
Working.
Oh, it's not working? Okay, thank you. The elevator was under repair, so we had to go a different route. So it just added 10 minutes, which wasn't too bad. No, time out. Why can't we just move that sign over forward? Go time! Alright, I'll fit to that. Get some salt on there, whatever that is. Teamwork is the dream work. Oh, gotta hang right. So the lifeguards actually offered to help me and my brother, but we knew that we would be able to do it just fine, having the both of us. So yeah, I just crawled with my hands and arms, and he carried my legs. And then once I got to about 3 feet deep of water, then I started to swim, so that way my legs and bottom wouldn't hit the bottom, and I wouldn't have to worry about scraping it. We also went into the Lazy River, but I didn't record that. At first, it took a three-man team to get in because I had someone holding the back of my chair, my brother was in the water, and then I would slowly lower myself, and then I would get into the water, and then getting out actually was a four-person team. Someone held the wheelchair, and then two people held me in the water because the current was carrying me, so I didn't want to like move. I had to stay in one spot to transfer up, and then I was the fourth person to lift myself with my upper body. But here the lifeguards just carried me out, which was really nice, and it made it a lot easier for me. And it was funny because they gave me their flotation device and all the kids thought I was a lifeguard out in the wave pool. Yay, Blue Man Group. Yay, Blue Man Group. Yay.
Gonna go uphill. Here we go.
It only takes one spin to win the $10 million.
Let's go.
Don't do it! Don't do it! This was me waking up at 5 a.m.
I feel so loved. I've been having dreams, splashing in the summer stream.
This was my very first Las Vegas experience where I was vacationing. Otherwise, I've been there for basketball tournaments, so it was nice to be there in the summer to enjoy the pools, the sunshine, and yeah, here's some footage at the Minneapolis-St. Paul Airport. It was my first time ever riding on a golf cart in the airport too, so it was kind of nice to get transported that way. But yeah, thanks for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you next time.
Getting stronger, step by step. The clock is ticking, but there's no time for me. I've been flying from town to town.